So hello my creative friend and welcome to another live stream of mine. In our yesterday's live stream, we've drawn this armchair, an egg armchair by Arne Jacobsen, and today's live stream will be all about Danish design once again. We will draw a mid-century Danish modern Finhjul chair. And let's begin. So if you are with me, all you will need is just a regular black ink gel pen and maybe a sketchbook. In my case, it's Moleskin, or just a simple piece of paper. So let's get started. And this lesson you can find on my YouTube today. My YouTube is Olga Sorokina. It's exactly my name, OlgaSorokina. Olga Sorokina. Let me write it to you. So Olga Sorokina. I'm originally Russian, so this is a Russian name, Olga, and Sorokina is my surname. All right, so let's begin. This chair, I really like it, and I've seen it several times in real life. This is Finhjul's chair, and some of you who are following me for a while maybe know that I lived in Copenhagen for 3 years, so I really fell in love with Danish design, Danish designers, Dansk Möble. I even learned some Danish there. So we begin by outlining basic contours by making basic proportions, so it's very draft part of our sketching. Sketching by definition means that it's something very draft and quick. So here's outline of our chair, and let me make some changes. I want this leg be a little bit closer to the left. So don't be afraid of any mistakes. You can always use a pencil and an eraser if you are afraid of mistakes, but I do not, so I can fix everything during this process. So, you know, when I lived in Copenhagen, I visited Finhjul's museum. It's right next to very famous Ordrup Gård Museum. Maybe you've heard about it in the section of contemporary architecture, because Zaha Hadid, our famous and favorite Zaha Hadid, she did a new part of the building for this museum. Its name is Ordrup Gård Museum in Danish. And Finhjul's house is located right next to this museum. So it's a really nice Scandinavian style, minimalistic piece of architecture, and very nice and airy interiors, a lot of light, a lot of space, a perfect location to for creative people, as I thought about that house when I was there. So, as you can see, we outlined our chair, and now let me find a marker which will be good for this furniture. I want it to be in earthy colors, so I will select two brown colors. This one is Touch Twin Marker. I use different brands. I love to mix and match different markers, and one of my favorites is markers with brush nib. As you can see, this is really a brush nib on the other, and they have a wide nib. So I will start by testing these colors. I want to see how they look together. Yes, I pretty much like it, and then I begin to add some coloring here. So first I want to outline this upper part of the chair, And then I want to put this color right here for this sitting part of an armchair. So if you are watching me live, or if you will be watching me on YouTube, please tell me in the comments, do you like Danish design? Because I certainly do. I was infected by Danish design when I was living in Copenhagen. And let me know where you're from, and if you are an interior designer, an interior design student maybe. Hello, interior design students. Welcome to my channel. Welcome to my live stream on Instagram. Maybe you are an architect. So you guys, please let me know. I'd love to know who's watching me. It's really interesting. So as you can see, I put some color for the leather part of this chair. So this part, it's a leather material, and this construction part is it's a wood. Two materials that are extremely popular among Danish designers. Almost all the furniture you can think of in Danish design is made primarily from these materials, these two textures, main textures in Danish design, I would even say, leather and wood. And in my opinion, they create this very warm, nice warm feeling. And before adding my dark brown color, I want you guys to add some shadowing. So let's assume that we have a light source placed somewhere here to the left. That's why we will get some drop shadows, which drop to the right. If we have light coming from the left, then we'll get shadows coming from to the right. And I want to add some background, because as you can see, I use here now complementary colors, even though they are different in tone. So this light blue tinted marker is really light. It's light indeed. And these two colors, they are much darker in tone, and in total it creates very beautiful harmony of a sketch. So final accents I will do with this darker colored marker. And this piece of furniture, once again, it's Finn Yule armchair model 48, in case anybody's interested what we are drawing, who joining us right now. Let's show some drop shadows here. I want to make this part a little bit bolder and to darken this part. I especially love Danish design in terms of craftsmanship, because if you take any piece of Danish furniture and you look closely at it, you will find that this piece of furniture is really a piece of art, because it's an object of high craftsmanship. Because each and every detail is deeply thought about, and it was performed in case of creation really beautifully. So for the details, I will use black marker, and I came up with the idea of white pastel pencil. So let me find my white pastel pencil. And I would love to emphasize a little bit this wooden and leather texture by adding a little bit of light here and there. So nice strokes Let's put it here. And in case you don't know, you guys, I have a special gift for you. I created a free video course for interior designers and interior design students who want to master perspective drawing. So it's completely free. Just sign up on my website. My website is olgaart888.com. And you will get this video course for free. There are seven video lessons for now. They all are short and sweet, about 7 to 15 minutes long each. So it's really very comfortable to go through this course. It's a completely self-paced online video course. You can join anytime, you can join today and start drawing in perspective. I cover there such topics as one-point perspective and two-point perspective in interior design and in architecture. So I hope you'll really enjoy this mini course, this perspective challenge, as I call it. There are more than 7,000 for now people going through it, so it's really very, very popular. And maybe final details, final accents. I want to emphasize a little bit this foreground because it's the closest thing, the closest part of this chair to our eyes. That's why we can see more details. So that's how this 3D effect, this aural perspective works. You just need to add more attention to things which are placed closer to your eyes. And yes, that's it. So once again, go to my website. It's olgaart888.com and find this free video course on perspective drawing. So my friends, I hope you enjoyed this live stream, and it was Olga Sorokina and my online school of sketching, and I wish you all a fantastic day and enjoy sketching. Bye for now and see you in my next live stream. Thank you everybody.